Nearly every brand, service, or product you see these days has a logo. You'll find it on their website, on social media, and all over their packaging. And I bet right now you could picture the logo of your favorite sneakers or fast food chain if I asked you to. That's what makes a standout logo. Universal recognition. A good logo helps you remember a particular business, and a great logo can even communicate things like the industry they're in and the product or service they provide. You've also probably noticed that there are lots of different types of logos out there. Some are made of text, called a word mark. Some are a single letter in a unique shape, called a monogram. And then there's the graphic logo, like an icon. So how do you start making a logo? Logo design in the real world usually starts with questions and some ideation, like sketching. In this tutorial, you'll see how to make a logo. You'll create the shapes that make up what we call the logo art. But before you get into the tutorial and lay the groundwork for the logo yourself, let's look at some key concepts and terms you should know before you start. Now, you might be tempted to start your logo by choosing color. It's a best practice to first create your logo in black and white. No colors just yet. There's good reason for this. A logo needs to be crafted with precision and has to look good at every size and when displayed in any medium. This is easiest to work out in black and white without getting distracted by those colors. But don't worry, you'll add color to your finished logo in the next tutorial in this series. Our first step in making our logo art is to start with shapes. Logos can be made of all kinds of shapes using tools like the rectangle tool. You'll also find tools to draw circles like the ellipse tool, triangles and other shapes, and even straight and curvy lines. Now that we have some shapes, we can refine them to best match our logo needs. For instance, for simple things like resizing and moving shapes, you can use the selection tool. But to reshape them, that's where the direct selection tool comes in. With the direct selection tool, you can move points to reshape this triangle to start making a wing. Illustrator also gives you ways to work faster to accomplish some of the more common and popular transformations, like rounding corners and merging shapes. Take the wing we just saw. These corners need to be round. You can do that quickly with the corner radius widgets in the shape. Now look at the head of the bee. We could draw these two shapes, but it's much easier to use the Shape Builder tool to divide this one shape into two. So let's recap. You can start with creating the simplest shapes, then modify them in different ways to create the exact shapes you're after to form your logo design. Now it's your turn. Start this tutorial with step-by-step instructions to practice making your very own logo.